All right, everybody. Welcome back to basketball with Mr. Berkey and Mr. Tull. So today we're going to be working on getting a basketball. You know, it doesn't need to be big or a basketball. It could be a big ball, a small ball, as long as it's not flat like a football again, you know, just like last time when we had Mr. Tull's volleyball. And it could be, you don't need cones. I mean, if you don't have cones, you can use cups like these. I mean, I have colored cups. You can use anything around the house, a small object, as long as you can dribble around it, as long as it's not glass or maybe some metal that you can hurt yourself. We're going to start with the greetings and attendings. We just did that. Our instant activity to get us pumping, what we learned today, our activities focus, and then we're going to review and close with our flip grid again.
All right. So for today, we're going to get started by doing a little cardiovascular endurance exercise. We know everybody loved our little scavenger hunt video that we did earlier in the year. So we brought another one of those back. It's going to get you up, get you moving, get your heart pumping so that you're ready to get moving when we do our defensive stuff. That is what we are working on today. So we're going to go to the next slide and get ready for our little scavenger hunt video. And just follow
it's
the
directions. Coach Russell's assistant.
We don't want anybody running through the house. Don't want you breaking anything. Walk, slight speed walk maybe, but no running, please. Listen to the video. You don't have to bring anything back to your room. Just go find it. If you can't find it, find something close to it. So if you don't have a banana, but you have an apple, hey, you got a fruit.
There you go. That works exactly. We're going to call it out just to help you a little bit as time goes on.
And hot shot. Welcome to Indoor Scavenger Hunt. Let's get started. Directions. Where you are standing is your spot. Earn 1 to 3 points for touching 1 to 3 of the choices and getting back to your spot in time. Each item is worth 1 point each. You have 30 seconds to touch the 1 to 3 items and get back to your spot. Be safe and walk. You don't score any points for getting back after the timer. Sometimes you may not have anything to touch, it's all luck of the draw. Only power walking is allowed. Or parents might get mad. Now it's time to start.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, so go ahead and find a hat, maybe a pencil or a pen, and just kind of a spoon around. You know, support.
What do you call a pig that does karate? Pork chop. What kind of shorts do clouds wear? Thunderwear.
Stop.
How do you put a baby alien to sleep? You rock it. Why did the banana go to the doctor? It wasn't peeling well. What do you get when you cross a snowman and a vampire? Frostbite. What do you call an owl that does magic tricks? Houdini. A space party. You plan it.
All right, looking for some milk. A computer that has to be a laptop. It can be like a desktop or a tablet that you use. Maybe something like that, and some shoes.
What do you get when dinosaurs crash their cars? T-Rex. What do you call an alligator in a vest? An investigator.
a glass. If you can wear glasses, a glass.
Your final score results. 0 to 5 points equals that you're a spectator. 6 to 9 points equals that you're a rookie. 10 to 15 points equals that you're a star. 16 to 22 points equals that you're an MVP. 23 to 30 points equals that you're a legend. Thanks for watching, make sure you subscribe.
All right, so hopefully everybody was able to get a really high score from that and got you up and get you moving around, got your heart beating a little bit. So for this week in class, we are focusing on defense. Last week we did shooting. In basketball, so we figured you know how to shoot, you might as well learn how to defend the shooter or the passing that we did earlier in the year. So we're going to be learning how to defend in like scenario, excuse me, learning how to defend in like basketball scenarios. So for our first activity, we've got a little mirror activity. So what we want you to do, find mom or dad or a brother, sister, or a partner somewhere. And we want you to set up a cone on either side of you, one behind you and one in front of you, and have the partner stand with the ball at the cone in front of you. And whatever way they move the ball is the way that you need to do a side shuffle while paying attention to them. If they move the ball up in the air, you jump up like you're rebounding a shot. And if they push the ball down on the ground, we want you to go down and touch the floor. You don't have to like jump down the floor, you just gotta put your hands on the floor. So for a little bit, we're gonna work on just moving side to side, back and forth, up and down. And throughout the activity, we've got a couple little progressions down here. Gonna work on just sliding three times, back and forth, stuff like that. Mr. Berkey, do you want to add anything to that?
Just make sure you know you're not on anything, you know, you can run over, you know, hit, break, anything that'll hurt you as well. Just remember to be safe and have fun.
But when you're standing in the middle, we want you in a good athletic position. Remember, you got to have your knees bent, head facing forward, eyes up so you don't run into anything. Remember, don't get sloppy with the footwork where you'll fall over and don't want anybody getting hurt.
Absolutely. We're going to give you guys we're going to give you guys 5 minutes, and then we're going to turn our videos off and let you guys do all the work. Go ahead.
All right, everybody. So hopefully you were able to work on your footwork and realize that defending is not a very easy task to do, and that it takes a lot of focus and proper technique to defend. Excuse me. So for our next activity, we're going to do something called cold, warm, and hot defense. But before we start the activity, we're going to explain to you what makes you a cold defender, a warm defender, and a hot defender. So a cold defender, you're going to be a distance defender. It's going to be if the ball's on the other side of the court and you've got someone behind you or someone to your side, you're a cold defender because you're not defending the player with the ball. Warm defender, you're playing man-on-man defense. So if Mr. Berkey is the offensive player and I'm the defensive player, I'm not up against him defending. I'm giving him a little space, but I'm still following his movements, making sure that I'm not giving him any easy ways to get to the basket or any easy shots. And if you're a hot defender, it's very aggressive defending. This is going to be your end of the game defense where you're trying to stop them from making that last second bucket. You're going to be very aggressive, not like hitting them, knocking them over aggressive, but you're going to be up near them, cutting off all lines of passing and shooting and stuff like that. So for this activity, we're going to get you and your partner just like the last one, except you're not going to need the cone behind you. The partner's going to stand in front of you and they're going to either yell the word cold, warm, or hot. Depending on what they yell is the type of defense that you will demonstrate. So if they yell warm, you're going to be off of them a little bit. Cold, you're going to stand back where you are and just make sure you're in athletic position watching behind you. And if they yell hot, you got to run up to them, play some hot defense. After a little bit of going through each type of defense, making sure you understand, you're going to start moving in different pathways. We've got, you're going to move in like a curve, like a snake, moving back and forth, working on your footwork, making sure that you're not getting tangled up in your feet, falling over, and a zigzag pathway. Just same thing. You're going to be moving. Your partner's going to be yelling cold, warm, or hot. You're just going to do that type of defense while moving. It's going to be a little bit more difficult. It gets you prepared for next week. Go ahead and start the timer.
All right. Hope everybody had a little fun doing that. So now we're going to be talking about our little health activity. We're going to be talking about salt. Because last week, you know, we talked about eating healthy and about the My Plate. So we're going to talk to you about salt. Salt is very bad for you when it comes to using it too much. So we're talking to you about showing you a video to demonstrate, you know, different foods that can use instead of salt, whether it's, you know, let's say ice cream, we could say maybe a fruit or a banana or something, or a salad, maybe instead of like a Jersey Mike's sub, something like that. So we're going to play this video for you.
Should be a slice of pizza that's almost halfway there. Pick up the menu, press pause, and have a salad instead. Is that saltless? Nope, but it's better. And you can have a whole lot of pepper.
Let's talk about salt, baby. Let's talk about MSG. Let's talk about all the good things and the bad things that we eat. Let's talk about salt. Let's talk about salt. Let's talk about salt. Let's talk about salt.
Now just stop, you got to make that blood pressure drop. It's what's in the pot that keeps your heart strong or not. People drool for food, just trying to satisfy their cravings. Those chips so good, that's monosodium Gouda. Mate, wait, hold up, maybe you can have the mashed potatoes served without the gravy. Check your plate before the shaker. Canned sauces, ham, sausage. Get out the freezer, find some food that's fresher. Think outside the box, prepackaged is a setup. Believe me, you can find a substitute. Canned goods ain't even that good for you, huh? Just check the label on the bag.
much sodium it has. It might say NaCl or maybe even GMP. And don't forget about the one they mentioned, MSG. End of the day, we gotta do our part. We gotta save our hearts right here and right now is the place to start. So come on, let's talk about salt.
Let's talk about salt, baby. Let's talk about MSG. Let's talk about all the good things and the bad things that we eat. Let's talk about salt. Let's talk about salt. Let's talk about salt. Let's talk about salt.
Ladies, all the ladies, laugh now, help me out, come on, all the ladies,
let's talk about salt.
All right, fellas, all the fellas, loud now, help me out, come on, all the fellas,
let's talk about salt.
Well, all right.
What we have here is subject to controversy.
Why?
You ever notice how some snacks make you thirsty? Too much salt goes straight to your bloodstream, causing extra work for your kidneys, and all that extra work possibly leads to hypertension or kidney disease.
Sheesh.
Let's talk about salt, baby. Let's talk about MSG. Let's talk about all the good things and the bad things that we eat. Let's talk about salt. Let's talk about salt. Let's talk about salt. Let's talk about salt.
All right, so hopefully everybody was able to pay attention to that video and learn that salt is not really healthy for you in large amounts, leads to high blood pressure, heart problems, causes heart attacks, stuff like that, kidney problems. It's not stuff you want to get caught up in really early in your life. So just limit your salt. It's not that hard. Just a little few shakes. Doesn't have to be a lot.
So now we're going to do a little bit of assessment. You guys are going to answer these three questions that we have here. You're going to answer them on Flipgrid. You're going to take a picture with your phone or maybe on your laptop to this QR code right here down at the bottom to the right. It's going to take you right to it. You're going to answer it. Take about a 3-minute video explaining, you know, the three types of defending and what they mean, what good footwork or why good footwork is important when defending, and why is too much salt bad for you. And that's it. And for next class, you will need the same ball that you've been using, the same amount of cups, cones, whatever you had before, the laundry basket we had in last week. If you didn't have that, I mean, if you even have a basketball hoop out front, or if you have like a trash can that you can use, something that can hold the ball, as long as it's not glass, something metal, something that you can get hurt with, as long as it's not that.
And you need a partner.
Absolutely.
Have mom or dad or brother, sister, best friend, something like that.
Yeah. And that is it. So we will see you guys all next week.
Yep.